Good morning, First AB. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. Honk your horn. Get on Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We're going to get ready to start church service, and we're going to start off with prayer, then we're going to turn it over to the officers. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for allowing us to come together one more time, Lord, to lift up praises to your holy and righteous name. Father, we come before you, Lord, bow down heads and humble heart, ask you, Lord, just to have a little mercy, Father. We ask you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, continue to bless this church service, Father, and the blessing, Father, we stand in need of, Lord. Bless, Father, and the whole world will hear your word through this service, Father. And Lord, we ask you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, continue to bless us, Father, with love, let flow from heart to heart and mind to mind. Lord, can you say in your holy word that we love one another, the world will know that we are your disciples. We ask you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, to bless those that are sick and shut in, Father. We have some that are home, some in the hospital, some in the nursing home, Father. We know, Lord, we call upon your holy and righteous name this morning, Father. If you just speak your word, just touch, Father, with the finger of healing, everything will be all right, Father. Lord, just like you healed a lady who had the issue of blood for 12 long years, Father, we believe, Father, you can heal, deliver, and set free right now, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we ask you right now to bless those that are traveling up and down the dangerous highway, Father, that they'll be able to reach their destination safe and sound. We ask you, Lord, to bless the man of God, that he bring forth your holy word on the anointing and power of the Holy Ghost. We ask you, Lord, to bless these officers, Father, when they do devotional service, to do it to glorify you, Father, on the anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost, Father. And Lord, we ask you to bless each and every one of us right now, Father, who's sitting right here and waiting to hear your holy word, Father. Some need you for one thing, some need you for another, Father. But whatever it is we need, Father, you know all about us. Just bless us, Father, because we need you and can't get along without you. Bless our governmental leaders to realize, Father, that without you, they can do nothing, Lord. Touch, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. We need you, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Heavenly Father, bless those prisons behind prison walls and hear your holy words behind those prison walls, Father. Heavenly Father, we know that you're the only one we need to be following right now, for your word is powerful. Oh, Lord, have mercy upon us right now. So much is going on in this world right now, Father. We need your divine grace. Have mercy, Father. This is your servant prayer, Father. In your son Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, church. We're going to do a hymn 492. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. What tossed the grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fear relief. How precious is that grace appear the hour I first believe. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. Touch grace have brought me safe this far, and grace will lead me home. Now we have a scripture by Brother Frazier.
Good morning, church. Our scripture comes from Psalms 1, and it reads, "Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of waters, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish." We give God praise for the scripture this morning, Psalms 1, in its entirety.
Amen.
Let us sing with uplifting voice. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. I had saved a wretch But now I am found, was blind, but now I see. Just grace that taught my heart to fear, and fear my grace. The grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fear relief. How precious did their grace appear the hour I first believed. Just grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fear relief. How precious did that grace appear. The hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. Just grace have brought me saved just for, and grace will lead me.
Again, we come before you, Lord God. Father, we come with bowed heads and a humble heart. But Lord, we come lifting up your holy and your righteous name. Lord, we want to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise, for you and you alone deserve our praise. There's no other God beside you, Father God. You are that true and living God, Father God. And we just want to say thank you. Thank you for all you have done, what you're going to do, what you're doing right now in and through our life. Oh, Lord, we just want to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Continuing to lead us and guide us, Father God. Let your Holy Spirit rest, rule, and reign in our life. Lord, let us not be about ourselves, Father God, but to be about your business. And, Lord, we just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
Please continue to be with those who are sick and in the hospital, those who are sick at home, those who are afraid and all alone, Father God. We ask you right now to comfort these your people, Father God. Touch, heal, and deliver, Father God. Lord, we just want to say thank you. Continue to be with the man that's going to bring our message today. Anointed from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet. Lord, continue to say a message we need, not just one we want. Oh, Lord, we just want to say thank you. And Lord, please be with this waiting congregation, Father God. Crown their head with wisdom, knowledge. Give them understanding, Father God. For you said all you're getting, get understanding. Lord, we just want to say thank you. Lord, continue to be this country, Father God. Be with those whom you have put in authority, Father God. Lord, let them know, Father God, that you're God and you're God all by yourself. Lord, we just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
And Lord, please be with this program today, Father God. Lord, we ask you to take charge and take control. But we know if you show up, you will show out. Lord, we just want to say thank you. Forgive us for sins of omission and sins of commission. Things we have said and done that is not of you, Father God. Lord, you say you throw it in the sea of forgiveness. And Lord, we just want to say thank you. Lord, we just want to say thank you. Father, these and all the blessings we ask it in your Son Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. That's all right, oh, that's all right. Yes, yeah, that's all right, oh, that's all right. Yes, yeah, as long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom. Say, that's all right, oh, that's all right, y'all, that's all right, oh, that's all right, oh, that's all right, Lord, as long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom, say, that's all right. Well, said you pray for me, oh, and I'll pray for you, Lord, cause that's the way us Christians do. As long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom, say that's all right. Oh, that's all right, y'all.
That's all right.
Oh, that's right, oh, that's all right. Oh, as long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom, say that's all. Well, if you get to heaven before I do, tell all my friends I'm coming too. As long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom, say that's all right. Whoa, that's all right, Lord.
That's all right.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, that's
all right. Lord, as long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom, say that's all right. Well, you talk about me, oh, as much as you please. The more you talk, I'm gonna bend my knees. As long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom, say that's all right. Oh, that's all right, y'all.
That's all
right. Oh, that's all right. Lord, as long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom, say that's all right. Oh, that's all right, y'all.
That's all right.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, that's all right.
Lord, as long as I know I got a seat in the kingdom, say that's all right. Amen, amen. Put your horns together. Amen. To God be the glory. Come on, give God some praise. Hallelujah. Our God is well able. I am so excited this morning. God is working it out on our behalf. Amen. Come on, give our deacons a hand clap. What a great job they did. Amen. Just want to be in the number.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Just want to be in the number.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
Let us bow our heads. Father, we come and we thank you this morning for your many blessings, God. We thank you for the food on our tables, the raiment on our backs. Most of all, God, we thank you that we're clothed, come on somebody, in our right minds. Father, we thank you for our families, those that are near, those that are far. I thank you personally that I had my children with me this weekend, and that was just a wonderful thing. I pray that you give them traveling mercies as they return to Atlanta and Miami, to their homes. And I pray you keep my grandchildren as well, Lord. Oh, yeah. Father, we pray now for this nation.
Yes, yes.
As we get closer and closer to a major election, we pray that you will touch the hearts of men in this country. And that you will have your way.
Yes, yes.
That's all we pray for, God, is that you have your way.
Yes, yes.
We can live with your way.
Yes, yes.
And we trust you now. Father, we ask now that you allow us to go down in your storehouse just for a little while. That we'll break the bread of life with these thy people. Is our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We give God glory. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
We give him glory. We give him honor. We give him praise. Once again, we thank our officers. We thank each one of you that thought it not robbery to come out to the house of the Lord one more time.
Yes, yes.
We continue to lift up our bereaved families,
yes,
Green family. We continue to lift up those in the hospital and the nursing homes. And we pray for our frontline workers as well, God. And God, we just continue to look to the hills from whence cometh all of our help.
Amen.
Amen. All of our help comes from the Lord. And we just trust you this morning, Lord. Amen. As I looked through the word last night and this morning, the Spirit of God took us to a person, and then the Spirit of God took us to a purpose, and the Spirit of God took us to the book of Nehemiah. So I want you to turn with me to the book of Nehemiah. Amen. The sixth chapter. Nehemiah, the sixth chapter. Amen. Very familiar passage of scripture. Amen. And then, before we read Nehemiah, God took me to a person. And the person that he took me to was Arthur Ashe. And many of you remember Arthur Ashe. Arthur Ashe was the first African-American to win the men's singles titles at Wimbledon and the U.S. Open, and the first African-American man to be ranked number one in the world. He was also a political activist who fought vigorously against apartheid in South Africa. He got South Africa banned from being on the tennis circuit because of their segregation, their white-only bathrooms, white-only water fountains, and eventually the world listened to Arthur Ashe. And the Lord put him on my heart today. Not so much because he won tennis tournaments, but because he put his own career in jeopardy to do what God has called him to do. And in this season that we're in today, I don't want you to get lax. I don't want you to be restrained. I want you to know your purpose. I want you to follow your purpose. Follow what God has put in your heart. A lot of times we look and we see hundreds and thousands of people marching, but really the true essence of the march may have come from one person.
Go ahead.
One person standing up. One person speaking out. One person risking everything that they have to do what God has called them to do. And so in that essence, I bring to you Arthur Ashe. Somebody that you need to know. Somebody that you need to follow. At the end, Arthur Ashe, through a blood transfusion, ended up with AIDS. And he fought a faithful battle, but he succumbed to that with pneumonia and died.
Well,
but he is still in our hearts. He is still in our memories. And he is somebody to be lifted up today. And so I just want to take our subject with the thought of Arthur Ashe. You and God can do this.
Amen, amen.
You and God can do this. We have to understand that if God is with us, no weapon formed against us shall prosper.
Amen.
I want you to understand that.
Amen.
There are going to be some weapons.
Yes, yes.
Coming against you.
Amen.
Let's look at Nehemiah as our example of how this thing worked back in the day. Nehemiah the 6th chapter. We're going to start on the 7th verse. And thou hast also appointed prophets to preach of thee at Jerusalem, saying, there is a king in Judah, and now shall it be reported to the king according to these words. Come now, therefore, and let us take counsel together. Verse 8, then I sent unto him, saying, there are no such things done as thou sayest, but thou feignest them out of thine own mind. For they all made us afraid, saying, their hands shall be weakened from the work, and that it may not be done. Now, therefore, O God, strengthen my hands. Afterward, I came unto the house of Shemaiah, the son of Deliah, the son of Mehetabel, who was shut up. And he said, let us meet together in the house of God, within the temple, and let us shut the doors of the temple, for they will come to slay thee. Yea, in the night will they come in and slay thee. And I said, should such a man as I flee? And who is there that being as I am would go into the temple to save his life? I will not go in. And lo, I perceived that God had not sent him, but that he pronounced his prophecy against me. For Tobiah and Sanballat had hired him. Therefore was he hired that I should be afraid and do so in sin, and that they might have matter for an evil report, that they might reproach me. My God, think thou upon Tobiah and Sanballat according to their work, and on the prophetess Nodiah, and the rest of the prophets that would have put me in fear. So the wall was finished in 25th day of the month, Elul the 52 days. And it came to pass, verse 16, that when all our enemies heard thereof, and all the heathen that were about us saw these things, they were much cast down in their eyes, for they perceived that this work was wrought of our God. Amen. You and God can do this.
Amen.
I want you to know this morning, church, that whatever God has purposed in your heart,
go ahead.
God can bring it to pass.
Yes, he can.
It doesn't matter if everybody's on the bandwagon. Doesn't matter if your neighbor agrees with you. It doesn't matter if your husband agrees with you or your wife agrees with you. If God has put it on the inside of you, God has made a way for it to come to pass. If God has called you, God will equip you. Here we see Nehemiah. And many of you are familiar with the story, but let me just recap a little bit. Nehemiah was a cupbearer for the king. Nehemiah was a slave. In the beginning, Nehemiah was from Jerusalem, and he received word that Jerusalem, the city, was in turmoil, that the walls around the city had been destroyed. Nehemiah was distressed by this news. There ought to be some things in life that upset you. There ought to be some things in life that motivate you to get up off your do-nothing and do something. There ought to be some things in life that just don't sit well in your spirit and that motivates you to get up and do something. And the first thing you need to do, you need to do what Nehemiah did. He prayed to God. Not only did he pray to God, but he went to the king. If it's important to you, it ought to be important to the king. Don't think that just because your bank account doesn't say dot, 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 that God won't open the door to the king for you. If you are lined up with God, God will allow doors to open that's been closed. God will allow some doors to be closed and allow you to open some other doors. You got to trust God. And so the proof of our trust is, do we seek the Lord first? The Bible says, seek ye the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and he'll add the rest unto you. So Nehemiah went to the king. And guess what? The king found favor with Nehemiah. The king granted him permission to return to Jerusalem. Not only did he give him permission, but he provided some paperwork. He divided some passes so that he could go through different lands. The king found favor with Nehemiah. God is good today. Favor is in the house today. Anybody need a little favor today? Favor is in the house today. I wish I had somebody who understood the blessings of God. That you are covered by the blood of God. Favor is in the house. If we serve God with our whole hearts and do what is right, God will grant us favor to do the work. He calls us to the work, and God will make a way where there's no way for the work. Now, immediately, we must jump into this lesson. Accomplishing your work will not be easy. As soon as the enemies of Jerusalem heard about Nehemiah and what he was trying to do, that he was trying to rebuild the wall, they got upset. They mocked him. They despised him. They lied to him and on him. And when people do this, what are you going to do? Chapter 2 and verse 9 say, for they were all trying to intimidate us, saying they will become discouraged in the work and it will never be finished. Chapter 6, verse 9, when you set out to do something good, the enemy will be after you in no time. It's inevitable that he's coming for you. The enemy does not want you to accomplish a great work.
right.
Your friends may make fun of you.
Yes.
Your family may discourage you.
Yes.
There are many sources of adversity yes. that we will face.
Yes.
So you must understand what I'm about to tell you. First, be prepared to fight against the enemy.
Amen. Amen.
Don't be foolish and think he won't come for you. He's coming.
Yes, yes, yes.
Chapter 4, verse 14 tells us, from that day on, half of the men did the work, while the other half held spears and shields and bows and armor. In other words, you got to be prepared for the enemy.
Yes.
You got to have your arsenal ready for the enemy.
Yes.
You might have to have somebody watch your back while you do the work. The enemy is coming.
Amen.
In the book of 1 Peter 5 and 8, it tells us, be sober.
Be sober.
Be vigilant.
Yes.
Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour.
Yes.
James tells us, submit yourself therefore to God.
Yes.
Resist the devil, and he will flee from you.
Yes.
So be prepared, church. You don't always have to go to combat with the enemy. Sometimes it's best to flee. The Bible tells us that they sent a message.
Go ahead.
A man by the name of Sanballat. He created a plan to have Nehemiah come down from the wall. But truly, they wanted to harm Nehemiah. So in chapter 6, Sanballat men go to the wall and speak to Nehemiah. They ask him to come down for a meeting, to which he replies, I'm doing a great work and cannot come down. Four more times they sent messages to Nehemiah. Four more times Nehemiah gave the same answer. What are you saying, Pastor? The Bible is telling us, stay focused.
Amen. Amen.
If you can help three people get to the pole,
go ahead.
Help three people. Don't give up because of what somebody else isn't doing.
Amen.
Or what somebody else is doing. You take your three people to the pole.
Amen.
You do what you can do. It is your reasonable service.
Yes.
You trust God in this situation. He said, I begun a good work.
Yes.
And I can't come down.
Yes.
I'm doing a great work. And I cannot come down.
Yes.
No matter how many times the enemy engaged Nehemiah, he never left his work. And because he never left his work, it tells us that God strengthened him. Ain't God a good God? When you feel yourself getting weak, when you feel yourself getting low, God will send ministering angels to you. And they'll build you up. When you feel like you just can't go on, he'll send somebody with a word of encouragement. The Bible tells us that Nehemiah say he can't come down. It reminds me of a poem by Dr. Benjamin E. Mays. Dr. Mays say, I have only just a minute, only 60 seconds in it, forced upon me, can't refuse it, didn't seek it, didn't choose it, but it's up to me to use it. I must suffer if I lose it, give an account if I abuse it, just a tiny little minute, but eternity is in it. I want to tell you this morning, you got just a minute
go ahead.
On this side of the Jordan.
Yes.
What you gonna do with your minute?
Yes.
Are you going to worry about what somebody's doing with their minute? Or are you going to have a plan? Because eternity is held in that minute. Are you going to know Jesus as your Savior?
Yes, yes.
Are you going to know the finished work of the Lord?
Yes.
Nehemiah said, I finished the wall. Verse 16 says, and when it happened, when all our enemies heard of it, and all the nations around us saw these things, that they were very disheartened in their own eyes. For they perceived that this work was done by our God. Our works can be accomplished by God for the glory of God. I want you to understand, he was on the wall.
Yes,
he was working with God in his heart.
Go ahead.
He was dedicating his work to God.
Yes.
The enemy came to try to distract him. He refused to be distracted.
Yes, yes.
It reminds me of my Savior. There he was on the mount called Golgotha. He had allowed them to pierce his hands.
Yes, yes.
He had allowed them to pierce his feet.
Yes.
He had allowed them to hang him to a rugged cross.
Yes, yes, yes.
He had allowed them to hang him high and stretch him wide.
Yes, yes.
He had allowed them to lift him up. But they had forgotten that he said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. They had forgotten that he came down through 40 and two generations with a purpose in his heart. His purpose was to die for you and to die for me. And so he stayed focused. Even when the enemy came to him, say, if thou be the Son of God, help yourself and help us. The other thief, the thief on the cross, say, if you be the Son of God, help me get down and help you get down. But he stayed focused. And the other thief said, can't you see there is no God, there is no sin in this man. He is the Son of God. Do you not fear God? And Jesus, he stayed there from the sixth hour to the ninth hour.
Yes.
Hung his head in the locks of his shoulders.
Yes, he did.
Gave up the ghost. Said, it is finished. They took him down off that bar, off that cross.
Yes.
Put him in a bar. Tomb.
Yes.
He stayed there for 3 days and three nights, but early Sunday morning, he got up with all power. He stayed focused on his purpose. I'm telling the church this morning, we got to stay focused on our purpose. The enemy wants to distract. The enemy wants to destroy. But Jesus said, if I be lifted up. Y'all gonna lift him up today? If I be lifted up. If I be lifted up. I will draw all men unto me. Not white men only. All men. Not black men only. All men. Not red men only, all men. Not brown men only, all men. He said, I will live. We are all in this thing together. We all need a Savior. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We all need a Savior today. Begun a good work. I begun a good work. And I can't. Come down. That school is going to get finished. That church annex is going to get finished. Oh, I wish I had a church today. You got good work. It ain't nothing to God. If God be for you, who can be against you? This is our time. This is our season. Don't be distracted. Don't let the enemy make you come down off the wall. You've got a good work, and you can't come down. You and God can do this. Come on, give God some praise. As we open the doors of the church, there may be somebody here today who has not accepted Jesus as Lord. Romans 10 and 9 says, if you confess with your mouth, believe in your heart that Jesus is the Son of God, and that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. When I say 60 seconds and eternity is in it, God has given us the dispensation of time that we might get this thing right. Within that minute, if you could take 5 seconds and say, I confess Jesus as Lord.
Yes.
Eternity is in it. It's in the 60 seconds.
Amen.
He gives it to us. Not for us to waste, but for us to get it right. Is there one today? The doors of the church open. Is there one today? All you got to do is step outside your car and lift your hands to the hills and confess Christ. Salvation is even in your mouth today. That's what it's about. The good work is about salvation. Is there one today? Is there one today? Come on, give God some praise. Come on, give him some praise. We're going to bless the offering, and then we're going to let you go. Do we have any announcements? No. Let us bow our heads as we bless the offering. Father, we thank you now. We lift up your holy and righteous name. We walk by faith and not by sight today, God. We ask you to continue to bless the saints of God. Meet us at our point of need, God, for we know that you are truly worthy to be praised, God. And we just walk by faith today, God, knowing that all is well with our soul. We pray, God, that we'll be able to get that roof on our school across the street, God. We just pray, God, that the clearing of the land will be expedited. We put it in your hands now. I step out of the way and let you come forth now with your power, God. And we just glorify your name. We look for a breakthrough this week, God. We look for a breakthrough this week, God, and we thank you for it. We call on your holy and righteous name. Be with the sick, the shut-in, the downtrodden, those behind prison bars, those in war-torn land. Bless every family represented here today. And we ask you now to return this 100-fold. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. We thank you. 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 Amen. Continue to tune in to Facebook. Continue to go to our website. Amen. Continue to let us know that you're with us, that you're praising with us. You can donate on Facebook. You can donate on our website as well. As God moves upon your heart to give, please give. We're trying to work on a building across the street, and that's just a project that's come from out of nowhere, so we need to raise money for that as well. So work with us. If you enjoy this ministry on Facebook, if you enjoy this ministry here, please support the ministry. Show that God is touching your heart right now. Our God is an awesome God.
Yes, he is.
Amen. And he's brought us too far. Come on, somebody. He's brought us too far to leave us now. So we thank you. We thank you for your participation. We thank our officers once again. We thank all of you. We're going to have to figure out a way to spread y'all out. I'm ready to hear some women sing now. We've been hearing these men sing. We're going to find a way to spread y'all out. We're going to make a joyful, come on somebody. We're going to make a joyful noise in the Lord. Your days of being off are over. Amen. We're going to figure this thing out. I'm ready to hear the women sing now. Glory to God. So we're going to work something out. Amen. Where we spread y'all out somewhere and you're not by each other. But we're going to sing praises unto God. And we just want to move forward. This is our season. This is our season to move forward with our projects, with our giving, with our love. Last week we did our food giveaway and that went well. Amen. So we're going to keep pushing and keep pressing. And we just thank you. We say hello to First Lady in our absence. She's doing better. Need some of that swelling's gone down. So keep her lifted up in prayer. Amen. And we just thank you. Amen. Let us look to the Lord. Father, we thank you now for another day's journey. It wasn't an alarm clock that woke us up this morning. It was you, God. You kept us last night as we slumbered and we slept. It was your finger of love that woke us up this morning. I thank you for my niece, Dee, who brought me this morning as we were dealing with a little tire problems. But God, we didn't miss a beat. We thank you. She came right on over and she Ubered me right, Ubered me right on over to church and we made it safely. Amen. So we say thank you, God.
Thank you.
We say thank you, God. You're so awesome. Things could be a lot worse, God. God, I see people every day with I'm hungry signs, I'm homeless signs. Be with the homeless. Be with the hungry today. Be with the weary today, God. Lift them up on every side. We continue to pray for the frontline workers, God. We continue to pray for those in authority that they will have sound judgment and will take care of the people. And God, we thank you for the word.
Thank you for the word.
By faith, let it now, God, be embedded in our hearts and in our spirit. We walk by faith and not by sight. In Jesus' name we pray. Now unto him who is able to present us faultless before his divine presence, the all-wise God, our Savior, in Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, amen. Come on, let us hear those horns. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Have a wonderful afternoon. Go, dogs.
That's me.
As for me. And my house.
We will.
Serve the Lord.
Serve the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Amen.
Boy, you know.
Hey, good.